You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension. A dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
We used to party all over town. We were in on every scene. We used to eat steak and lobster, mama. Now it looks like fat back and pinto beans. Won't somebody tell me? I'd like to hear all about it if you think you know. Yeah, I'd love to hear all about it, baby. Where did all our good times go?
Fresh off a third vaccine candidate garnering U.S. regulatory approval, billionaire philanthropist Bill Gates called the rapid development of vaccines a miracle that should help Americans return to an almost normal way of life as early as fall, but also warned that lawmakers aren't doing enough globally to usher in a full return to normal before the end of next year. Speaking to CNN's Fareed Zakaria on Sunday, 65-year-old Gates said that autumn should bring about some normalcy for Americans, with basically every school back in session, some level of occupancy in restaurants and sporting events all once again taking place. The big problem is that we're not doing enough to end the pandemic globally, Gates warned, adding that vaccines thus far are just going to rich countries, which leaves the risk that contagious variants could spread abroad and creep back into the United States. That risk, compounded by the potential wave of reinfections, means a full return to normal could take all of 2022 unless we do a better job, Gates said. Additional vaccine factories in nations like India could help curtail the risk of infection abroad and bring about a quicker return to normalcy.
Have anyone in charge?
I'm in charge.
You have a name?
Goldsmith.
This place, does it have a name?
And if it does, Major?
If it does, Father, we'd like to hear it.
Who are you?
Major French is my name. Central States Command. We're being sent around to organize.
Organize?
Yes, that's what I said.
Are you ready to go if a vaccine is approved tomorrow?
Yes, we are.
What's the first order you're going to give?
It's a simple command of execute.
Don't put this food out! Your hair is contaminated!
True, Mr. Goldsmith.
Stop it! Listen to me, all of you! Listen to me! There's every possibility that all of those cans contain enough strontium 90 to kill every man, woman, and child in this village.
Nobody would have predicted that I and Dr. Fauci would be so prominent in, you know, really kind of evil theories about, you know, did we create the pandemic? Are we trying to profit from it? And on and on. And so, you know, I'm very surprised by that. I hope it goes away. I hope it doesn't hold back, you know, mask wearing or seeking out vaccines. The percentage that's really misled by these conspiracy theories, it's unclear to me. There's millions of messages out there, you know, where my name or Dr. Fauci's name is used. But do people really believe that stuff? You know, we're going to have to get educated about this over the next year and understand, You know, what? How does it change people's behavior?
You've got enough food in that pile over there to feed us all for a good long time.
There's enough poison in those cans to kill us all in 10 days. Most of it was canned after the bomb. We've no idea where it came from. Who processed it?
All right, let's lay it on the line there, Mr. Goldsmith. Here now. Come on, who'd like a nice square meal for a change, huh? Anybody else? Dig in. Okay, anybody else want to continue to play kindergarten games with Mr. Goldsmith here? Go home and chew on an old bone.
Now, don't be fools! Don't commit suicide!
Good morning to you, Margie. Well, the National Guard soldiers are self-proclaimed heroes who go into communities to help however and whenever they are needed. And now the governor is hoping that they can put boots to the ground and really speed up this process in getting more residents vaccinated against COVID-19. So Governor Parson, he says each team will be able to administer as many as 2,500 doses a day. To boost efforts, the first mass vaccination site opens this week. 30-member vaccination teams made up of National Guard troops will break off into the 9 different highway patrol regions. Special 4-member teams will be here in St. Louis and also in Kansas City. There they can home in on the most vulnerable populations in the state's major cities. Now, they will be giving the shots and doing paperwork that goes along with getting vaccinated. Health officials say they're challenged when it comes to getting people registered and putting their information in a database. The biggest challenge still, the availability of the vaccines. Health officials in the densely populated St. Louis County saying they've only gotten around 4,000 to 5,000 doses of the vaccine, but they have more than 200,000 people already signed up and on the waiting list to receive their shots. Now, the governor says they're expecting more than 76,000 more doses and another 76,000 doses by the end of next week. The other mass vaccination sites are expected to open by the end of this month.
Please make sure your sleeves are rolled up high so they do not interfere with the shots. Sticker should be centered high as well. From this point on, there should be no talking unless you or the person next to you needs medical attention. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Sticker on the back of your hand and go to ma'am.
18, no allergies.
Sub in the box. This is Tunerix. Hepatitis A, hepatitis B.
18, no allergies.
Sticker on the back of your hand.
18, none.
Sticker on the back of your hand, go to ma'am.
18 ounces. We talked about the ways that men could die. We forgot the chief method of execution. We forgot faithlessness, Major French. Maybe you're not to blame. Maybe if it weren't you, it would have been someone else. Maybe this has to be the destiny of man. I wonder if that's true. I guess I'll never know. I guess I'll never know.
Mr. Goldsmith, survivor, an eyewitness to man's imperfection, an observer of the very human trait of greed, and the chronicler of the last chapter, the one reading suicide. Not a prediction of what is to be, just a projection of what could be. This has been The Twilight Zone.
This isn't just a word from the sponsor. It's simply a very good suggestion. It stands for real refreshment. Before we meet again, try Oasis for the softest taste of all.